Hello everybody, here I am again, Els, Elizabeth Craft Designs. How are we doing? Oh, it works, that's great. Let me see, comments on. Alrighty, so I'm a minute early, so we're just going to wait and see if you are here. Yeah, I see Karin, Wilma, and three other people, so it is working for sure. Hi everybody, hi Yona. It is going to be playtime. Well, so you know, every life is playtime, of course. I just showed you, like, it's really coming down here, the snow. So it's really going to be interesting to see how we get home. Hi Daniela, Sarah, and Gertina, and 13 other people. Hi everybody, thank you for watching, of course. Thank you for coming here. And so Anna was skiing, but Marley is here today for the comments. Thank you, Marley, for being here. And so first of all, winner from Wednesday is Linda Bas Poldervaart. Well, Poldervaart is Dutch. Bas, I don't know, with double S it says. But so Linda Bas Poldervaart. So you won the $50 gift certificate. So please email info@ecraftdesigns.com or we will contact you as well. So congratulations. Hi, Patricia, Michelle, Lisa. Hi, everybody. Dorothy, Thea, Bouwland. Hi, everybody. So before I forget to say, I see Marley will put it in the comments as well. So we have a special with the glitter and the tape. And that's kind of how this all started. Glitter and tape, 20% discount using code SPARKS20. And because this is tape, they called me yesterday or a few days ago. They said, Els, the washi tape will be in the special as well because that's tape and that's kind of how it is in our system. So the washi tape, the double-sided adhesive, and all the glitter is 20% off using the code SPARKS20. It's both in Europe and in the US. Oh, my internet is down. Dorothy, we had it at home yesterday, but they fixed it this morning. And I'm waiting I'm actually waiting for it here to go out, but that's not going to influence the live because it's so bad here, the internet, that I actually turn off the internet. And that works better. That's also why I had, like, I know some people said they were like the screen was shaking last time. That was because I had it on the internet here. So I forgot to turn it off. But if the internet goes down, I cannot see the comments anymore. But so far we are good because they're working on it here as well. Hi, Suzanne from Australia, Texas. No snow here. You know, it's beautiful snow. It will be good. They actually take good care of the roads. And as long as you are, as long as you're driving carefully, you're fine. Hi, Karen. Happy Friday for you as well, I hope. I hope you feel better. Hi, Anita, Yolanda. Okay, so what are we going to do? So I told in my little info video already, like my intro, this was my idea. I thought I'm going to make a phone booth in glitter and the whole, you know, I was going to demo that. But then sometimes I got just carried away. Oh, Ans, mijn dochter heeft, oh, you get a surprise package. That's nice. So then I get carried away and I just finish it. And then I think, okay, that was my demo for tomorrow. But so this is all tape with cardstock tape on top and glittered. The flowers from our floral collection, the berry branch, the Merry Christmas from Suzanne Cannon. And then the tape here, the washi tape around here. Oh, you got your set dies too? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so this was fun to do. This was fun to do. I love playing with the glitter. Every time I pick it up again, I think, oh, that's super cool. But, you know, so this is finished. But, you see, so I put acetate in between. So I showed you that in another video already. And then here I put the door inside as well, kind of to finish it off nicely. Because I like my window to be in between two layers, so it's really a window. So that's kind of what I did here. So you see, I used a gold, silver, the transparent one, and the berry branch, some transparent craft drops on there. And here I did the Merry Christmas with embossing powder, also on the tape. So fun, and of course, this is a slimline card, so you can stand it up. So that's this one. So I'm going to put that aside, because that kind of went out of the window, that idea, because that is already finished. Oh, and for the special, I have to say it ends the 22nd of December. Will the small Merry Christmas come back in stock? Angelique, I will check that, the one I used here. I will check that for you. And if Joep is watching, because he is taking care of that mostly, or Mark. So we need this one, the small one, back in stock. It could be that it's on order, but I honestly, I am not involved in that process. But I will check it, Angelique, for sure. So what I did here. So then I started, and I have to say, with washi tape, I was not a big washi tape user, I have to say. And, you know, I had it at home already, never used it a lot. And now yesterday I started playing, and I am super excited. It is so much fun. And so I used it a little bit. You know, I did my cup. That's actually where my excitement started. And I know I had those with me. Where did I leave those? Oh, this one. It's still in the bag. You see, when I did these ones, like the cups here. So that's when I got really excited about washi tape and embossing powder. And so I made this one. And then I know I have another one in here. Or do I have that somewhere? Oh, I know. That's somewhere else. Oh, I have one here with glitter. The other one went in my TN. Here. That is with washi. And I don't know if you saw it, but I did all kind of different cups. So this is in one of my other Facebook lives, you see? So all those, so that's when I really thought, oh, that is super cool. You see, I did the border with the washi and the cup itself. And that is so much fun. And in that same video where I make that cup, you will also see that I use the glitter and different ways, you know. There's so much. But so this is what I did already. So I did the front and I did the back. And I will show you how, you know, I'm going to put this together and then I'm going to show you what I did here. I also did it on a book, like a notebook that I had. But then you see right away that washi, because washi is not opaque. So you see the difference between white and white, you see. So that book was black. So you see it kind of comes out a little bit darker, but still super cool. So I did front and back of the, also something I thought, oh, I'm going to do that one. and then carried away again and did this one. And that's how I ended up going to bed way too late and standing up going up way too early, because I need to have something to do here and I finish everything. So yeah, Petra, I'm super excited about the washi. I have to say, when you see what I'm doing, it's fun. So this is a little notebook from the HEMA in the Netherlands, closed now, but because of COVID. So I put gesso on this one because it was bright pink. So I thought, oh, I'm just going to gesso that one, and then it's white. So if I get to this one, but you can imagine, you just buy some, notebooks and just gesso it, and then put your tape on there. But I will get to that. So let's put this one together. So I did the front here. So I started with this one, tape on top of the cardstock, because our tape is, like, this is the 4 1/4, I think, and this is the 6 inch. And then, of course, we have all the small rolls, and I use this every day, all the time. If you don't have a big roll yet, that's absolutely worth the investment, because it's, but use it. Have it at hand all the time, because sometimes I get people at the, like if you do an expo, I get people at the expo, and then they say, oh, I bought it last year, but I never used it. That is, you know, put it aside, because I use it all the time. I die cut all the things that I want to stick down. I die cut those with tape on the back. And you will see now with the foam booth, although I'm going to use washi tape, you will see that if you want to put glitter or embossing powder in between, it is so nice to have that whole piece in tape. And if you buy a big roll, I think there's 27 feet on it, so there is a lot. There is a lot of tape there. So if you buy one roll, you know, it will take you a long time to empty this. So this is the door, you see. In this case, I'm just going to put a window in with vellum. And I choose vellum because I thought, I'll show you in a second, because it kind of tones down this part. And I thought it was nice in this case. But that's, yeah, Angelique, you have the 4 inch. Love it. Yeah, it's the... It's the 4 inch or the 6 inch that I use most. And it's especially because we have a smaller one, and I don't have that one here. It's a 64 millimeters, so it's about this size. And that is nice as well. And of course, for backing, for cardstock to die cuts, that's fine. But if you want to work with glitter, butting it up, the tape, for glitters, you will always see the seam. So that's why I, 25 meters. That's 27 feet, I think it is. But yeah, there's a lot of tape on there. Angelique, roll it off and then see how long it is. No, I'm joking. You can tape your feet if that helps, but I don't think so. Not a smart idea. Because taking it off, and when we are at shows, customers are always talking about this one as the toilet roll, because it's kind of a toilet roll size, but don't use it as toilet paper. That will not be fun. Although in times of need these days of toilet paper, maybe put it on, there's all kind of creative ideas. 2.5 inch, that's the other one, Angelique. Yeah, that's the other one. That is the one that is, you're kind of helping me here, Angelique. You're kind of helping me here. That's very much appreciated. Here we go. So that's that one. And then this is going on here. And I am going to use expensive toy. Yeah, Jonah, but you know, honestly, here people were sending when everybody was kind of in that rush for the toilet paper. People were sending toilet paper from different states to, for instance, California. Honestly, they had people, family, buy toilet paper somewhere else and sending it to California because people were really stocking up on their toilet paper. So, and I saw a picture from somebody in the Netherlands that actually in the Netherlands it was this way now again. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Joop. ecraftdesigns.eu, that's for the people in the Netherlands, yeah, or in Europe, sorry, in Europe. So we have a warehouse in the Netherlands as well, and it's also on sale there. So the code is SPARKS20. Okay, so now this one, while I'm doing this, I'm thinking, because tape on washi, I don't know if that sticks really well. Let's see, just to be sure what I will do, because the washi is very slick. So what I will do, I will take a little bit of wet glue as well and just put it on the border. Just to make sure that it sticks down for sure, because I forgot to think about that. So let me save myself here. And because that will definitely work, because I tried that somewhere else. Here, I'm just going to touch it lightly around. So I am sure it sticks, even if the tape will not stick. But I think it will, but I don't know for sure. But I don't want to be surprised. Okay, so this one is gone. So now, and this idea came from Leonie Peugeot from Hochanda, because she said, oh, a graffiti phone booth would be cool. And then I think I was talking to Esther that we said, oh, that's, we should do that with the washi tape. So the washi tape I used here is only the Reminiscence one. There you go, you see. How cool is that? I think that's super cool. Then in the idea of the... I need to put this around it. Am I going to do this or am I going to do the... Yeah, I'm going to keep it in a washi. There's no tape on this one. There's no tape on this one. Because you cannot cut double-sided. Yes, that's why I made the graffiti for... Yeah, Yona, exactly. You made one already. Yeah, it is super nice. So I'm going to do wash of tape again here. So this is the 3 mil, and then thinking about it now, I think I'm already short in time. All the ideas. That's what I had, so many ideas this time with the tape and the glitter and the embossing powder, because you can heat emboss on the tape as well. Hi, Ruli. Greed is so sad, we just can't understand it. Seriously. Yeah. Yeah, Debbie. Yeah, we didn't, if it's about the toilet paper, we didn't stock up, I have to say. And I know at that time, that was at the beginning of the pandemic, we actually had one show when this all started and we were on our way home. And because that's the only show we had this year, on our way home. And then we stopped at the supermarket. And there was toilet paper there. And I know I took a picture, because that's already when everybody said, oh, there's no toilet paper anymore. So we were able to kind of easily buy it in that little town. Hi, Simona. And I see decorate their homes, making Christmas tree decoration. Yeah, you know, it's time for crafting, huh? You know, I heard on the news here, they had an idea, and I don't know if it's going to happen, but like there's a film channel, like HBO or something, that they, since everybody needs to stay home, they are talking to HBO, like that's one of the TV stations, about having it for free for people during Christmas time. Because normally you pay for HBO Plus or whatever, and giving it for free so people can watch all the movies for free. That would be a nice thing to do. Okay, you see, so here we are. Then I have, because I thought, oh, the graffiti painting, blah, blah, blah. I cut these two from the TN collection, kind of dripping paint. So I thought that would be cool. And I cut these pieces. Oh, I have red and black, I see. Where's my inside part? Oh, I don't have my inside part for here. Well, do they leave that on? I don't know. Where should I have that? Well, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. So I'm definitely going to do some dripping here, but I'm going to trim it, of course. So something like here. Let's see. Hi, Babette and Gina. Hi, everybody. So please like, comment, and share to make a chance for the $50 gift certificates. Oh, I can do it here because it's kind of the red paint dripping. Like, comment, and share. And next week we will do, I said already, we do something special. But as everybody at the company knows by now, I'm not a big planner ahead kind of person. But it will happen. So we'll do something special. I'm even thinking about doing a Zoom. But Mark is looking into that because I know I can do that at home. But we need to set it up. We need to set it up. Because we do a Zoom meeting sometimes with the ladies from the mountain as well. You see, I think that's cool. So that's my graffiti. Roelie says, ziet er gaaf uit, Els. Thank you, Roelie. So now question is, do I want another one here? Or do I not want another one here? No, I don't want another one there. That's too much. Then I think I'm going to put this one in black here. Or I can do it in red. Oh, I like the red standing out. But I'm missing the part that's inside. I think I cut it out of black. But apparently I don't have it here. Joep, can you look on my desk at home? It will be there somewhere. It will be there somewhere. I'm still going to do, you know, I'm going to stick with a little bit of glue all the time because I think, Babette is in Germany. I love Germany. We have stores in Germany carrying our product for sure. For sure. Okay, that one. Love that. Need to trim the, need to trim this part of the washi here. And then I have this part. Am I going to, oh, I had it in red. And I cut everything in red. And I'm going to put that one there here. I leave it because I have silver embossing powder here. So I don't need the, oh, although it looks cool. Why not? Dresden. On your phone numbers, Els. What are my phone numbers? There is double-sided adhesive on my, no, oh, that's not, no, that's not the part. This is actually the leftover of the black one. I know what you mean. Yeah, that's the leftover from this. And I cut the, like the locks and the hinges out of that one. But I know for sure I had it. So it's, I'm pretty sure it's here somewhere. But that's fine. That one. And I'm going to make a label there with a telephone as well. I like my paint dripping, I have to say. I think it's officially a coffee stain. But of course you can use it for anything you want. Okay, so that's that. And then I have my hinges here. So this one I'm not going to use. I choose the other color. And then I'm going to glue these on with the tape if I need to put glue on that. I will do that later. Oh, it actually feels good. Now I need to watch where the line is, but I'm not going to really open this one, or I might put a picture behind it, but and I hope I will have some noise during this hour, because we're waiting for a pallet to come in, which they promised us like for 2 weeks already, I guess. Oh, I should do this out of silver or something. I might replace these. But now the last time it was Wednesday, and then they said Friday, and then we said, well, Friday it's going to snow. So then they have the excuse we cannot drive up on the mountain. So the chances that the door will open here in the second building to bring in something will be minor, I think. Minor. Okay, put that aside, and I want to put this one in here, and I think I'm going to put it like a little bit to the side, that you kind of see this here. That was kind of the idea that I thought, oh, that's another kind of cool effect, because it's not a I think I have a memories. Oh, I don't know about it. You will know which customer orders from us in Germany. Otherwise, you can go to the EU website. But if there's a store here, but I don't think we have stores from Germany watching here. And with shipping these days, honestly, it's a hit and miss. Because some packages arrive next day and some you need to wait. Ooh. I like that as well. No, the idea. Stick with the plan, Al. Stick with the plan. So this, and then I wanted to kind of hang that little tag out of here. You see? So that. I thought that was cool. And then this one is going on here. So this is going to be a page in my planner. So I'm going to put that on here. And of course, if you want to do a slimline card out of it, you... Oh, the shops are closed? Yeah. Yeah, I know for sure the shops are closed. So it will only be online anyway. Yeah. Or maybe you can pick up at the store, like curbside pickup. Other than that, it is no shopping in stores. I think here stores are still open, but you can only like have 20% capacity. I know Canada stores are open. They have 15% capacity. So there's not a lot, yeah, you know. There's not a lot of fun shopping these days. But we have online. We have our craft room. We don't need to spend so much money on clothes because, you know, you're inside anyway. Sweatpants. Joggingbroeke in Dutch. Yes, so. But then, of course, you know, try your jeans on every now and then as well, because otherwise you will be so disappointed when the time gets back that you have to wear your normal clothes. So that's good enough. Okay, so that's that. And then I'm going to do reinforcements. I will do that later, and then this one can go in my, and of course the back will be the washi as well. But I'm going to do something else first kind of forget to do this. Oh, where's it going? I don't even know if I'm going to put it in this one. Oh, it will fit nicely here. And of course, we have the phone booth reinforcements. But I think this is super cool, of course. That's just such a cool element in your journal, in your planner. So, oh, and before I forget to say, because the phone booth, I know we had questions, does the phone booth fit in the Sidekick? Well, I didn't adjust it or anything, so made it sure. I didn't do that yet, but I don't think it will fit. But what will fit, this is a Sidekick page, so it actually fits the door super nicely. So definitely going to do that one, you see? So the door of the phone booth will fit. You use jeans? Yeah, in your art journal. Yeah, Ilse, exactly. Maybe cut it apart before we start fitting. That's probably a more safer way. So Ilse, I don't know if you were here already, but I am going to work with the washi. And it is, well, I'm working with the washi already, but I'm going to put this away. So next, playing with the washi, I also made this one. the pizza box, and that's a little bit more sturdy, like so it's but it folded actually really nicely. So pizza box for a present, and here I use the different tapes, so that both the this one and both this one. So the washi artsy scenery, I need to turn it around, yeah, artsy scenery and the reminiscence. So that's both on here. And before I go on to the next one, I want to walk you through these ones, because this is from Dana Fink, made these a while ago already. And I said, well, we had so many new releases, so I didn't get to walking through these because I had new releases all the time. So, but I really need to ship this now to, because she made this one for Angel and she made this one for me. And what Dana does, she makes junk journals. And you've seen one that she made before already. But she makes her own journals, but then uses all the planner dies and the Sidekick dies in there. So only look at the charms here. Like, it's charms galore. So it's with elastic bands. And so so this is Sidekick dies. You see, so, and pockets. So she uses all kind of stuff here. You see planner essentials. So, oh, your leggings. Yeah, Dorothy. Yeah, yeah, I know. But be careful, eh? Be careful. Don't let yourself fold. But you see, so she makes all those books herself with all, like, real junk journals. But you see, she uses the pages from the Sidekick collection. And there's here, there's all kind of things happening in here. So I don't know if Angel is here. I don't know if Angel is here. But Angel, it is super nice. And I will send it to you today. Here, planner essentials, you see. Some glitter. There is so much. She makes her own pockets. Here you see from the TN collections. So she used the border. And then she used it as a stencil as well. You see the reinforcements there. So she just plays with... Oh, you're here, Angel. This is yours. This is coming your way. I will make sure they send it today. I hope it makes it before Christmas, because it's really, really nice. Look, Angel. So she has all the charms here. It says breathe. Oh, that's a good one. You see all the charms here. And then the elastic band that goes around it that says believe here. So it's super, super nice. So this is coming your way, Angel, today. So memories, that's also planner, you see. And then... it is so cool. All the pockets here. Extreme memories. Be happy, shine bright, and be you. So it must be a stamp. But that's from another. Here you see the tags here. That's from Planner Essentials. So just so much going on here. So that's this one. Here, borders from the TN collection. Love it. And she made me that other one. Oh, again, TN. Oh, this is the one I use for the... Oh, you see, she just slide this one in here as well. So this is from the TN. That's that butterfly pocket I work with on Wednesday. You see? So pocket, little notes in there. It is so cool. Here, the border again. She backed it and then trimmed it. That's Planner Essential. Oh, I love this. Here, so she... This is actually Planner Essentials. And then she cut that twice. And then on the bottom one, she used the border from the TN. You see, she is so she's so creative. An ECD charm. Oh, you know, we so need to work on those kind of things. Here. And then, because, let me see if I have... Like, Ilse and Charlie are very good in that. They make all those extras when you do something with them. Here. That's from Ilse and Charlene. So cool, so cool. One day. You see, so Angel, this one is coming your way. I absolutely love it. And then Dana makes the whole thing. So she makes everything herself. But I like the idea that you can combine everything, like the planners, the journals. And I noticed something from, I think she uses Eileen Hull's covers to make the covers from Sizzix. So... love that. So that's coming your way. And then I got this one. And I don't know exactly what she did anymore. But it has to do with shoe polish. But a very special shoe polish. Oh, don't stay too long at the office. It's snowing on the mountain. Oh, okay. I will drive carefully. Yeah, it's coming down here as well. But after this, I will come home. Yeah, so this is mine. So here she used the planner dies. And what you can do, of course, if you have a planner die, basically what you do is you fold the paper and make sure you don't cut this line. And then you can slide it in something else. So that's the very simple way to say what she did here. But here you see that's one of the planner essentials. That is, so this is all planner essentials. This one, of course, the arrow page. And this is, I know she stamps her own paper because you see the flowers here. This is vellum that she created herself. Is Dana here? I don't know if she's here. I forgot to send her a message. I should have sent her a message. This is a border from the planner essentials. This one is cool. So, and she did it in, I think in the earlier one she made for me. So this is the tag pocket. That's in one of the planner essentials sets. And then she stacked them. So now I have one, 2, 3, 4 pockets. That's super cool. So this is 4, but I think you can fit 3 probably in your TN. Let me see. This is a TN page. Yeah, you see? So you can make this 1, 2, 3 times for your TN. Super cool. Super cool. And see here, and more an envelope here. This could be just be an envelope that she kind of changed. Here another pocket. So cool. Paper from Esther, I see. And then here, look at that. So cool. Did she sew that? I think it's in between. I can't see. Look at that. Oh, I see some craft drops here. That's what you do with a book from Dana. It's kind of every time you go back, you see... do you mean Sidekick? Yeah, the Sidekick. So this was a Sidekick page. Sorry, did I say that wrong? So for this one, this is a Sidekick page. If I said that wrong, yeah. Sorry about that. If that was wrong, you see. So this is mine. So I'm playing with that. Oh, and then she makes little holes, eyelets, and puts things in there. It's so cool. Here, that's all the reminiscence paper. Here, the tag from Esther. Oh, here are all the tags. Love that. Love it. You see, I have it since fall already. That's how, from the end of October, because that's why she put it in. And here's some extra pieces that I can use. Just cool. This is printed on something. She printed our logo on plastic. Yeah. So that's Dana's. So finally. Finally. So I will send yours out today, Angel. And then I hope you get it for Christmas. If not, I am sorry. Okay, there we go. Tape and glitter. And because what I wanted to do, and it's actually that started with the idea from when I thought, oh, I'm going to show the books from Dana, that I thought making your own cover. Because if you want to, you know, if you want to make a planner for somebody like a family, friends, whatever, you know, and you don't want to buy a planner or a Sidekick or a TN all the time, you, of course, you can make your own cover. The dies, because those dies, the basic dies, are simple dies. You cannot, like, when it's intricate, it doesn't work. But when it's a simple die like the page, you can actually cut through chipboard. This is a kind of a, you know, this is sturdy enough to make a cover. So that's what I did here. So what you use for that, and I made a TN page and a page for the planner. So this one, I just had a piece of chipboard. What you do, so this is the TN. You take that strip, make sure you put the cutting edge on the outside, of course, and I just line it up on the cardstock and you run it through. Then you have this, and now you can, you see, so this is chipboard, but this drops out easily. And then I put it on my, and I don't know if the slider, I actually use a guillotine at home. I will try if it works, but normally I use a guillotine, but I don't have that here. Then you see that line here, because this cuts as well. You see, hi Astrid, and Monique, and Nie, hi. So you see this, you see that's a cutting edge here. So I see that here, and I see that here. So I can use that as a guideline. So I'm going to line it up, and let's see if it does this as well. Oh, I'm too high. You know, with the guillotine, it's easier. I'm a little bit too high. You see, let's see if I can get a... Because at home, I always use my guillotine because that's just... I can do it very precise. Oh, I'm good now. Here I am. That's that one. You see, and then you have your cover. And now line this one up. Let me see. I should be good like this. And then you trim this one. You see, and now I have my cover page. So I can do that with the planner and with the Sidekick. And I think especially when you work with kids, you know, when you want to have kids make their own journal, this is a fun way to work because you can paint on it, you can do anything with it. And then of course you can use the rings to kind of make the book. And those rings are, you know, I have a few sizes here. Hi, Nell. And before I forget to say, if I don't see everybody again on Monday, Merry Christmas and a happy and healthy 2021. Let's hope it's a better one. You know, although I cannot complain, but it's for a lot of people, it's not been perfect. But Merry Christmas, everybody. But I'm here on Monday for sure. So here, you see. So those rings come in all kind of different sizes. So if you want to do something with kids and you think, oh, just a few pages, you just make a book with a few pages and those rings. And I buy those. I know craft stores have them, but I buy them at a, you know, at a office store here. But that's whatever you want, of course. So I made this already. So I'm going to show you several things. So this is two small pages. And then here I have a large page. So what I do first, I cover the page. Now let me do a small one because I have a large one covered already. So for the small one, you can actually use that. Yes, that will actually fit perfect. Just if I make it a little bit smaller, but to be safe, I'm using this one. And this will be a little bit too wide, but honestly, there's so much tape on here. So you waste a little bit, but that is fine. What I'm doing, I'm just covering it. And of course, you can, if you're careful, you can save all the bits and pieces. But I, in this case, I'm just getting rid of this part. So what I do, I just take my craft knife and trim around it. So that's how I cover my pages. And of course the washi is sticky, but this just works so easily. And because I want to do glitter or foil or embossing powder in between the washi, that's why I just cover the whole page. That, and now you see you have those little holes left here. And I, oh, where's my little, I know I had it here. I have a little punch. Still in my bag. Just a second, because I know for sure I took it with me. And I actually thought I took it out of my bag, but I don't see it. Let me see. No, I can't find it. Else mess. Okay, so what I did with the other ones, am I sure I don't have it? I actually know 100% sure it is here, but I don't see it right now. Okay, so what I do at home, I have a little punch and I punch out the extra tape there. You see, that's what I did here. In this case, I don't have it. So what I will do in this case, I will just punch through here and do this. But I like that punch better, of course. But if you don't have it, you can do this. But it will not look as nice as with the punch, the holes. But it's always somewhere. It's always when I say when I... the mischievous elves are hiding things, nee? For sure. Because I know for sure that I took it out of my bag, but probably not. Because I don't see it. If it shows up, I'll tell you. So this is not as nice, of course. So you want to have nicer holes. But, you know, it is what it is for now. It is what it is. And I can, if I trim that nicely, I can, you know, it will be nice. But, okay, so those are my holes. So that's my page. Now I'm going to take this off. And I'm actually going to use my tweezer for that. And, you see with, I'm too far away. Oh, there we go. I'll take this off. You see, now that's all sticky. So what I did, because, I'm going to do my, so what I did here, I just lined up the washi. And the washi, of course, so is also 20% discount if you tuned in later, because washi is tape in our system. So you get 20% discount on all the glitter. and the tape and the washi tape using code SPARKS20, and it will end the 20 seconds. So you see, this is the different washi tapes, and they combine really, really nice. Okay, so now this is all sticky. So instead of doing this, so here you see I had the tape, and I did, I just left open spaces, and I did foil and washi, foil and embossing powder in between. What I want to try now, what the idea was, that I am, and when Yupa's here, you know what I'm talking about, because what they have here, I want to do foil, glitter, and embossing powder. And the idea in my head this morning was turquoise. Like they sell really nice tabletops here with turquoise in there. Very expensive, by the way, if you have real turquoise in there. And that idea came to me when I did this part. So this is on the tape. This is only foil and embossing powder. I'm going to lift it up because it actually looks really nice. So you can make a cover like this for your book. And then stencil on it, or, you know, so you can do a lot of different things with that. You can do a lot of different things with that. So what I did is I did, and I can't get myself in trouble there, but I, oh, it was James, Angel, James took the, yeah, let's blame James. That's a good idea. That's a good idea. I cannot stand because I know for sure I had it, but you know, that's how it goes. So what I did, I took some of the release sheet from the tape. So basically what you can do, if you have this one, I can tear this. So, oh, Dana, you're late. Dana, I just showed your journal. So you need to, your junk journals. So you need to go back, Jane, Dana. I just showed them. So this now will be my little turquoise in on there. But, you know, maybe it's a thing that just works in my head. So when I see that turquoise on the art, it is kind of like this. So I'm making, you see, I'm making a stencil now. And in my head, I think I need to do this first before I go to the rest. So I'm going to make two pieces of, like two little veins of turquoise on here. This is cheap turquoise compared to the real one. I'm going to overlap this. And this one, I'm going to open a little bit that way. Okay, let's see. Can you imagine turquoise? So now we need a large piece to kind of press that down. So I'm going to use this because I need to make sure that's pressed down well. And what I need to do now is make sure that my glitter doesn't go underneath here, because then it will be a mess. So I will have two veins of turquoise. Then I'm going to take my glitter tray. And this tray I normally have at Expo, but since we don't have Expo. So you've all seen this, but this is shimmer sheets. And that is that's on sale for cheap, I think. But there's still some left. And that's with stays on, alcohol inks. Super cool stuff. But yes, you know, we had it now for a longer time. So this is just a patchwork of shimmer sheets. And then you see the different colors here. That is stays on. Because I actually demoed that at the expo. Because if you take a stays on ink pads, you can actually rub over. Do I have one here? No, I don't. You can actually rub over this and then it will lift the other, yeah, Navajo Crafts. Yeah, exactly, Angelique. That's where it's coming from. But they make table covers here. It's so gorgeous. It's so gorgeous. So this is my tray here. I need a coffee filter. Yeah, shimmer sheets. Shimmer sheets is cool. There. So then I want to have a turquoise color. Oh, that's also nice with the gold. Do I want a stronger color or do I want a lighter color? No, I'm going for the stronger color. So this is a blue streak. Blue streak. So that's going to be my turquoise color. So now I am doing this here. Brush it off. And the rest can stay there. And then I'm going to do the same on this side. So you see, so for the covers, because I also was picking up, I have a lot of postage stamps at home. So make a collage of postage stamps. Oh, somehow I didn't have, I don't know if I have tape there. I should have. So postage stamps is super cool to make a collage, or you know, if you work with kids, of course, you know, get a kids magazine or whatever and cut it up to make a cover. Kids will love that. They might even appreciate it more than like a real planner or a, you know, it's just fun to kind of have them be creative. So now I polish this in here and let me show you the difference, and the rest I'm going to brush off here. Because if you polish, and you need to polish in between each color, I always tell it, but if you look here, you see that it's really shiny. If you look here, that's still a little bit dull. So by polishing it in, you really make it shiny. And now I can wipe this off with a Swiffer, but in this case, I'm just going to remove this. Oh, that will be cool, I think. That actually looks really pretty. That's fun. So this idea kind of came up, as I say, in the morning. And then I think, oh, I need to try that. I need to try that. And I think that's going to be cool. Okay, so now I have this here. So what I'm going to do now, I have gold foil. I know I have that. I even know where it is, which is great. So this is a piece of gold foil. I'm going to put it over here, but I don't want it to be like totally covered. So I'm going to touch it lightly because I want to have some spots left for embossing powder. And some glitter. I don't know if I do. I think the rest I'm going to do embossing powder. You see, so what happens now? And I could do glitter as well, but I think I like the combination of glitter, embossing powder, and foil. You see, it's getting there already. That. And then I'm going to take my embossing powder. Oh my goodness, I have a mess here on the floor. Almost looks like I'm in the studio in at Hochanda. The trash cans are always too small. And what is nice about the embossing powder, what it does on the... On the tape, it gives a really nice texture. And of course, depending on which embossing powder you use, it is it will react differently. But and I'm not going to brush this off because it can be anywhere. That's fine in this case. The only part I actually don't want it is on my turquoise. So I'm going to take a brush to kind of take it off there. Yeah, Nell also, yeah, fijne feestdagen for everybody in the Netherlands. Merry Christmas, everybody. And again, if I do something with the Zoom, I'm really going to try if that works. I will, of course, post it on the planner on the ECD page. It almost looks like the tape didn't get there. I might have ripped it off, but no, we're fine here. So now I have that. And I'm going to heat emboss this. Now you see, because then I get the different textures. So now I have the glitter, the embossing powder, and the foil. Oh, it's going to look nice. See, I'm quiet. That's how I'm impressed of the result of this. I'm quiet. Hi, Belinda. Yeah, the Wednesday gift certificate is Linda Bas Poldervaart. Linda Bas Poldervaart. Alrighty. Here we go. It's actually really pretty. See? Isn't it nice? And then, of course, I can like put a name tag here or something if I want to make the fronts. I'm going to push this through and then I will do some reinforcements there. And then the back will not look as nice, but as long as the holes for now look nice. And then you can do the same on the back, of course. If you want to do the same technique on the back or something different, you can do that. You see, so now I have a nice cover for my journal. So I did take some reinforcements. I also took stencils. And before I check out and forget to say, we still have a few cameras left, I think. So if you don't have this one yet, this, I cut this one now with tape and cardstock. And I want to do a washi tape cover with that one. Or one like this, because I really like that as well. So that's the tape. So if you don't have any of the big rolls yet, and this is your chance, of course. It's at one, I don't know exactly the amount, but there's free shipping on a certain amount. And, you know, get one of the big rolls. Because, and of course, the small ones, like, and the sheet. We have the sheets, but like the smaller rolls, I think we have four different sizes. But then one of these is really, really handy. And honestly, just use it, because there's so much, so many possibilities, so many possibilities. Okay, so what do I have? I want shiny. I'm just going to do simple. Oh, but I also have, you see, this is also fun. I have, I don't think I'm going to use them on this one because I don't know what it's going to be. But this one I cut out of turquoise Christmas trees. Could be nice. And let me see. I'm going to do the shiny. Yeah, Linda, you love it. Yeah, the camera die set. Honestly, that is the best sold product ever for Elizabeth Craft Designs. And if you don't have it yet, when they're gone, they're gone. Now, they're not going to be reordered. So if you don't have them yet, get your hands on it, because the camera die set is really, the camera kit is really, really nice. Kind of need to see where the hole is. There we go. I'm just going to keep this in gold. So this is the gold cardstock from Tim Holtz that I have here, because I like that it's not too... yeah, glittered reinforcements. Let me tell you about that, because I actually had that prepared as well. I had that prepared, but I don't want them on here. I want to keep this simple, but I'm going to tell you something about that. Because all my reinforcements I cut with double-sided adhesive on the back, because it's just super easy to glue them down. If you have, of course, if you use it as an adhesive, it's, you know, it's you used it, so you cannot, there's not adhesive on two sides. But in some occasions, you can do that. And I actually tried it this morning. So I actually have that prepared for today. But in this case, I like the... you see, I like this, and just a name tag here or something, and that will do it for me. So how nice of a cover is that if you make this for somebody? And you know, I could have done a little bit more of the turquoise if I want to, but how cool is this if you want to send a friend, a planner or a sidekick, and you make your own covers? So these are the two I have here. And I'm absolutely going to make more, because I have one left for my planners. And then, of course, I cut two, so I have a front and a back, you have rings, and you put your pages in here. Another thing, so what I did cutting these, I measured just outside. So what I did is I took the die, I took a die with a tab, like this one. And then I just measured my cardstock a tiny little bit wider, because Esther, when we designed these planners, we did, it was very specific. Because Esther didn't want to have, you see, this planner ends, like the tabs really end at the end. She didn't want like a lot of leather or fake leather, of course, sticking out here, that you have a lot of to show that here. So if you look at this, you see, and of course it's the big rings as well, so you can make this bulky. It is a flexible one, so not all out there are flexible. So the flexible one is, you know, because then you can make it bulky, because if it's a stiff cover, you cannot fill it up as thick as you want, you know, because then it's standing out like this, and this one is going to bend. And but you see here, so really the dies end here. So that's what I did measuring this one. I just made it a little bit wider than, you see, than this one. So when it's going to be bulky, you will see all the tabs here as well. So I think that's just a cool way how she did that. So I have these ready to go. And then about those reinforcements, these ones are actually foil and embossing powder. So what I did cut some of them, so this is not too thick cardstock, simple shape. So don't try to do the snowflake like this. You can do circles, you can do this one, that's a simple shape. So thin cardstock, and then I had tape on both sides. But you don't wanna foil or glitter them first, because when you run something through that is thicker, which this is, it will push out, kind of, it will push out the tape a little bit. So when you glitter this first, this piece, and then run it through, this will feel sticky because of the sides. So don't do that. So what I did here, I had double-sided adhesive, and I will, no, I don't want to put them on here. But basically, let me take a piece of cardstock. So now, oh, that's also double-sided. I just need cardstock, or a piece of paper, whatever. So this is just paper. So now this is double-sided. What you can do then you can put it on your holes, of course. So you take your book and put it on there. So that's on a hole now. Then you can take this off. So now that's sticky. So don't do it first and then run it through, because that's not a good idea. And now I can take my foil. I can do the same as I did with the book. I can just press this a bit. You see, now I have foil, but not everywhere. And then I like, because I like the combination of either glitter or embossing powder. So now I do the embossing powder, and then I heat this, and then you will be fine. And now it's not sticky. So that's, but only with easy shapes, because if it's too sticky, or if it's too intricate, it will not work. Absolutely not. So only, you see, and now I have a reinforcement that has foil and tape on it. And that's what I did with these ones. You see, so you can do the circles, you can do the this one, but I have, because I actually took my reinforcements, and you see, but don't try to do the leaves, don't try to do the snowflakes. This one will probably work, but you won't see the embossed lines. This one will work, so you can clearly see the ones that will work. This one absolutely not, this one absolutely not. So just try, you will notice it right away. But that's just a tip, because I always want double-sided adhesive on the back of my reinforcements, because it's just so easy to do. So that is an hour again. So I didn't get to this one. I will do that during the weekend probably. So I have that. So again, if you do the book here, I had a craft color, so you will see it shines through a little bit as well. If you look at the book here, you see, or at the box here, that was a white box, you see clearly the difference. So be prepared on which background you do the washi. But I honestly love this as well. So washi tape is 20% off. Using code SPARKS20 on glitter tape and washi ends the 20 seconds. Like, comment and share, please, for your friends. And subscribe to our YouTube channel. Anna always says, oh, else don't forget to say subscribe to our YouTube channel. And all our Facebook lives go to the YouTube channel as well. And again, if I don't see you on Monday, I wish you all happy holidays already. But of course, I hope to see you on Monday at 8 o'clock Dutch time and 12 o'clock here. So thank you. Have a wonderful weekend. And see you soon. Bye-bye.